إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد الله سبحانه وتعالى he says in the Quran إن عدة الشهور عند الله 12 شهرا في كتاب الله يوم خلق السماوات والأرض منها أربعة حرم ذلك الدين القيم فلا تظلموا فيهن أنفسكم. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he tells us in this verse that the months in the year are 12. There are 12 months in the year. And in those 12 months, Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us that there are sacred months that Allah has given superiority over every other month in the year. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the hadith of Abi Bakrah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, which is found in Sahih al-Bukhari, the Messenger tells us those 4 months. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, As-sanatu thna ashara shahran, the year is 12 months, minha arba'atun hurum. And in those 12 months, there are 4 sacred months. Thalathatun mutawaliyat. The Prophet said 3 of them are consecutive, meaning they are after one another. Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hijjah, and Al Muharram. And then the Prophet said, Wa Rajabu Mudar, alladhi bayna Jumada wa Sha'ban. And the month of Rajab, which is attributed and ascribed to a particular tribe called Mudar, because they used to venerate it and respect that month, which falls between the 2 months of Jumada and Sha'ban. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us what those 4 months were that were stated in the verse. As you can see, my beloved brothers and sisters, every single month in the year are not the same. For the year has in it months that are given status, that are given virtue. ولذلك العز بن عبد السلام رحمه الله he says تفضيل الأماكن والأزمان, the superiority and the virtue that is given to places and times are of two types. The first one is تفضيل دنيوي, worldly virtue, and that's not what concerns us now. The second type of virtue that is given to the year is تفضيل أخروي, hereafter virtues. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He chooses within the year months that He wants to reward the righteous slaves so they can accumulate more deeds. As you all know, we're now inshallah ta'ala approaching a noble and great month, Shahrullah al-Muharram. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith al-Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih min hadith Abi Hurairah, أفضل الصيام, the best fasting بعد رمضان, after the month of Ramadan, is شهر الله المحرم. It's the month of Allah Muharram. Two benefits we take from this hadith. The best fasting after Ramadan is in this month Muharram. One. And the second one is the Prophet attributed to Allah by calling it شهر الله المحرم, the month of Allah Muharram. And this ascription is إضافة تعظيم, it's to venerate this month and how glory and great it is. Al-Imam al-Bukhari narrated in hadith ibn Abbas that Abdullah ibn Abbas, and he said, ما رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتحرى صيام يوم. Abdullah ibn Abbas, and he said, I did not see the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم exert all of his efforts and try hard in fasting يوم فضله على غيره إلا هذا اليوم, except this day. Which day is it? يوم عاشوراء, the day of عاشوراء. And the day of عاشوراء falls in the month of Muharram that is approaching us. In Imam Muslim narrated that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said صيام يوم عاشوراء, the fasting of the day of عاشوراء, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said إني أحتسب على الله, I hope from Allah أن يكفر السنة التي قبلها, that Allah will forgive the sins and the shortcomings that came the year before. So this month is a virtuous month, a noble month, but there are rulings pertaining to it. There are fiqh and understanding that can be taken out of this month, Muharram, and also Ashura. Also, there are righteous deeds that can be done, that the pious predecessors used to do. So here at Kalima, we inshallah ta'ala want to invite you to a lecture that we're going to be discussing ahkam, rulings, and benefits that we can take out of this month, Muharram. Anything which I have said that was wrong and incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.